and sympathize with you. What you have gone through. No parent should have to go through. But there are questions you have not answered. And under the Portuguese, the Spanish, the English police, they have been looking for your child. Far longer than they've been looking for most other children. There must be something special about yours. I have questions I need answered, and I need you to answer them before you get any more help. Detective Nimrod. This is not an official interrogation. You may have your own free will, we understand that, but to help us, you need to answer questions. Okay. Your daughter went missing on the 3rd of May in 2007, about 2200 hours, 10 o'clock, Spanish time. When you entered the apartment, what did you see? What did you do? Where did you look? Did you search inside the master bedroom wardrobe? If you look in front of you, you will see two photographs that were taken of your bedroom wardrobe. Can you describe its content? Why was the curtain by the sofa near the side window tampered with? Did someone go behind the sofa? How long did your search of the apartment take after you detected Madeline's disappearance? Mrs. Mccan, we need you to answer these questions honestly before we can help you. Why did you say that Madelyn had been abducted? Let's assume that Madelyn had been abducted. Why did you leave the twins to go to the tapas bar and raise the alarm? The abductor could still be in the apartment. We need more from you here, okay? If you want to help you, we need answers. Why didn't you ask the twins what happened to their sister? Why didn't you ask them later on? When you raised the alarm at the tapas restaurant, what exactly did you say? What were your exact words? What happened when you raised the alarm there? Why did you go and warn your friends instead of shouting from the veranda? Okay. Who contacted the authorities? Because it obviously wasn't. Who took places in the searches? Did anyone outside the group learn of her disappearance in the following minutes? Outside of your group of friends, of your contacts, did you tell anyone else before you told the authorities? Any neighbours that offered to help you? So after reading through your statements, a question we need to ask is, what does "we let her down" mean? Besides, you left her and the twins. So you know a woman called Jane Teller. Did she tell you that that night she had seen a man with a child? Okay. How were the authorities contacted? Which police force did you contact? During the searches, with the police there, where did you search for Maddie? How and in what way? She could still be out there. Why did your other kids, the twins, not wake up during that search when they were taken upstairs? Did you give them something to sleep so you could go out? But considering what's going on, the bigger picture is much smaller than that. You need to answer these questions. I can't help you unless you answer honestly. Who did you phone after the occurrence? Did you call Sky News? This may be taken out of context. Did you know the danger of calling the media because it could influence the abductor? Okay, I'm going off tangent here, but the media registers, the abductor watches, the abductor changes behavior. better fix the case. Okay. Did you ask for a priest? Child's missing, you asked for a priest. Okay, you say didn't. By what means did you divulge Madeline's features? By photographs? By other means? Madeline had a specific pupil. She would still be recognizable once. Now, this is a question I would understand why you do. Is it true that during the searches you remained seated on Maddie's bed without moving? What was your behaviour that night? That night. Did you get any sleep at all? Before travelling to Portugal, did you make any comment about a foreboding or a bad feeling? You did. How was Madeline's behaviour before? If you need to take a break, we can do that. God. Please take her outside for 2 minutes and we will continue the interview shortly. Thank you. Okay. We shall see you shortly. You're watching that too, yeah? She's lying. She's lying, this. There's something about her that her reactions don't seem right. I don't know. I've got some questions to go, but I don't think she's gonna crack. She's got 10 years practice in this. Okay, you might be right, you might be right. Yeah, bring her back in. Questions ago, and then we need to round this up. Okay. Did Maddie suffer from any illnesses or was she on any medication? Okay. her twins are brother and sister. What was Madeline's relationship like with them? Did they get along? Was there conflict? I know your question is, Vanessa. We need to get the facts. You know, what the twins have said, what you said, it is... We don't ask these questions, we won't know the answer. Okay? But you need to answer them. What was Madeline's relationship like with not just a brother and sister, but her friends, schoolmates, social playdates, you know? Was she socially active? Relevance of the question, I understand why you're questioning, but it gives us a better profile of how she would act in situations, you know? Okay, I understand. So, both you and your husband are doctors. Both worked for the NHS. In your professional life, how many and which hospital personal, this could be professional, there are just, there are so many, it's been 12 years, there are too many variables, and we need you to answer these questions. We can't help you out. Okay. What is your medical speciality? Have you ever done shift work in any emergency services or other services? Did you work every day? It is a relevant question. At a certain point in recent times, you stopped working. Why was that? Okay. Are the twins difficult to get to sleep? Are they restless? Does that cause you uneasiness? Understandable, children are difficult. Yes. Obviously, it pays attention, you know? If the kids were asleep when the time the incident happened, they might be witnesses. We're getting into some difficult questions here. But I need you to be honest. Isn't true sometimes you despaired at your children's behaviour and it left you feeling very uneasy? I'm not here questioning your parental ability. I'm just trying to get the facts, okay? I'm here to help you. But to help you, I need you to help. Is it true that, back in England, you even considered handling Madeline's custody to a relative? So, this is a touchy subject, but back in England, did you medicate your children? Legally, illegally? What type of medication did you use? In the case files, you were shown canine forensic testing films. After watching them, did you say you couldn't explain any more than you already had? When CSI and the authorities brought in the sniffer dogs, they found marked human blood behind the sofa. Did you say you couldn't explain any more than you already had? When the sniffer dog marked the scent, we happened a very long night. When the sniffer dog marked the scent of a corpse coming from the vehicle you hired a month after the disappearance, did you say you couldn't explain any more than you already? You have to help me. When human blood was marked in the boot of the vehicle that you hired, did you say you couldn't explain any more than you already had? Confronted with the results of Maddie's DNA carried out in a British lab, collected from behind the sofa and the boot of the vehicle, did you say you couldn't explain any more than you already had? Did you have any responsibility or intervention in your daughter's disappearance?